Hello everyone, welcome to my living room, 8 p.m. just in time for this very special live. First of all, thank you all so very much, you know, for being here with me wherever you are in the world. I've seen a lot of reposts of the picture of the guest, the special guest we're gonna have tonight, and me that we posted. So thank you so much. I see already a lot of messages. Hello. And I'm going to start right away. You know who's going to be my guest, but for whoever missed it, for some reason you were sleeping under a rock, we have a great singer, a great woman. She's super sweet, super smart, and I know that we're going to have a lot of fun tonight. I prepared some questions that you guys made, and I have myself a lot of questions, so get ready. It's gonna be an interesting night. Let me see if she is online already. She should be. Sharon, I'm searching for you in between the names. Send me a request to participate to the chat. Please, guys, don't send a request to participate, because tonight we're gonna have one special guest. Where are you? Okay. Let me see. I don't see the name in the list. Let me see. Let's be patient, guys. You know, we're not all super fast with technology, and I'm doing my best. Okay. Be patient. You're gonna see my face. I'm gonna do little dances while I'm searching for Sharon in the list. You guys are trying to get online, but I will call you next time, maybe. I don't see Sharon. Where is she? Sharon, be patient. I will be able to get you in. Again, go to the beginning of the chat, and there should be a request to enter the chat. There she is. Oh, answer the question.
Hello!
Yeah!
Yay!
We made it! I was sweating.
Me too. You know, normally I start a chat. I don't participate most of the time. So it's like, how did I do this? But it works.
It is not an easy task. They should make it even easier. Type the name of whoever you want to invite. And no, you have to go through the chat.
I had to go outside because you couldn't find. It's like, okay, then I have to go out again and then participate again.
I'm so happy about this chat. How are you?
I'm fine. Luckily, everybody around me is safe and healthy, and it's the most important thing.
That
How are you?
The most important thing. I'm doing okay, and the guys are just fine. My family is okay. Where are you? Are you at home?
I'm at home. I'm in Holland. Yeah, with the family. Yes. Luckily,
how is the situation there? Is the quarantine still on? Was ever on?
Yeah, it was, but it wasn't extreme as like in Italy, where everybody was really restricted to stay inside. Here, you were able to go outside and even jog if you wanted to. And I'm close to a forest, so I'm actually really lucky. But when you're, in a city, it's more difficult, of course. You were only allowed for 10 minutes in a park, and then you had to go again because it was too crowded a lot of times.
Yeah.
But here in the area, it's just great. I could do a lot of, I had a lot of freedom still, and I have a garden, which is also nice. But I can imagine being in an apartment, not having, a balcony or a garden.
And yeah, that's me.
Go crazy.
That's me. 2 months in this damn apartment when going out for groceries and just like throwing garbage. It was like, yes, I'm going to make up and meals. I'm going to throw the garbage out. Hated it. But now we can go out as well more than
great.
We used to. We can, work out outside, we can walk in a park, we can visit relatives. And it seems that in a week some shops will start reopening, so
okay, that's great.
Fingers crossed.
Life gets a little bit normal again, luckily for everyone.
It was very bad. So I arrived prepared because I
Oh, you
know
came prepared. Oh my God, I didn't prepare anything.
no.
I felt like a lot of people will ask questions and I will pick some questions or something. I don't know how we're gonna do this, but it's gonna be fun.
I came prepared because I'm considering reading all the questions online, but
Okay.
it's easier if I prepare something
Yeah,
instead of just like
totally.
scrolling, which is
Yeah.
always a chaos. First thing first, I'm so happy to see you because I mean,
Yeah,
we've been knowing
likewise.
each other for so long, but I haven't seen you in person for years.
No, the last time we saw each other was in Berlin at the Metal Hammer Awards. That's
Yes,
already
that was a few years ago, 4 years,
yeah,
5 years
4 or 5 years ago already. Time flies, huh?
Time flies. Time
Yeah.
flies for sure. Actually, some people ask me how long have we been knowing each other. I don't remember the very first time that we met.
Well, I remember the first time I saw you live. That was on Dynamo.
Ooh,
I
Dynamo.
think, yeah, it was, I think, Dynamo 99 or maybe 2000. I don't know. I think 99 probably. And I saw you playing, or we didn't meet afterwards. But then we saw in America. Of course, we went on tour together. That was the
Yes.
real time that we first met, actually.
Yes, and that was 2007, right?
Yeah, it was the
Wow.
hottest chick of metal.
Yeah.
You know. Yeah, exactly. Oh my God, whoever
Was a
came up
fun
with that
tour.
name? That's not even possible nowadays anymore to come up with a name like that.
No. It was hottest chicks in metal, then turn into hottest chicks on hard rock.
Yeah,
Yeah,
something like
it's gonna
that.
be like the cutest. It has to be more politically correct because I mean,
Yeah,
it's
nowadays,
you can't really say
they don't dare anymore. Cheers to that, by the way.
Oh, I
I
forgot to grab.
brought the
I
wine.
wanted
Did you
to.
bring the chips?
What are you drinking? What
I
are you
said,
drinking?
I'm drinking a rosé.
Rose, I forgot. I wanted to grab some Porto,
Oh,
some because
really?
I love Porto wine, and I have like two or three. I was
Oh,
like,
really?
I'm gonna get ready, and then I started cooking, and I took a shower.
And you forgot all about the nice drinks for yourselves. Oh my God, girl.
Well, it feels like I'm doing it.
I just ordered someone. I got Robert.
Yeah, I know.
Bring me
I'm
some
by
wine and we're
myself now,
going.
so I can't even. Let's
Yeah.
bring a drink. Now,
Unfortunately, there's nobody there.
no, not at the moment because my
Oh.
boyfriend is working now, so I'm by
Oh, okay.
myself and I'm doing a lot of stuff, preparing a lot of stuff, cleaning,
Okay.
ironing, writing music, working out, drawing. I
Yeah,
kept
yeah, yeah.
myself busy in
Yeah,
these
sounds
days, and
very
I'm going,
busy. Oh,
and I'm going to video games soon. So, a
really?
lot of,
Cool.
yeah, because I love video games. So that's what I do in regular life.
Okay,
When I'm
cool.
not on tour, let's talk about the not touring. How are you
The not
feeling
touring,
about
yeah,
that?
that's, yeah. Well, what do you do when you're not on tour? You play video games, like you said, and what more?
Yeah, as I said, I do stuff in my house. I mean, I used to, when I'm on tour, I usually visit a lot of friends. I go out, for restaurants. I'm not a party girl because I mean, I live on venues as you do as well. But I like to have a
Yeah.
good time, with my friends and just doing stuff that I left behind at home.
Yeah, and just catching up with friends in their lives and yeah, making new memories with them as well.
Yes, normal stuff. Normal stuff. I don't do anything too crazy. I mean, I like, the normal life when I'm home because it's so
Yeah.
hectic whenever we are on tour that I
Do you
like
feel
to
like
chill out.
that's what I feel sometimes when I come back, I really have to get 2 weeks for myself to really get into the new rhythm of home because, you know, life is so different at home and as when you're on tour, you know. When I'm at home just after a tour, I'm always like, oh, do we have for dinner? Because everybody's always cooking for us or we have a restaurant. And I totally forget there's a different way of approaching how to go about when you're having dinner. It's like, maybe you should have brought me something or maybe you should have cooked something, Sharon. So
And it feels so
you
weird
have to
because you're
think.
constantly surrounded by people when you're on tour and you
Yeah.
go back home and it's like, where's the noise? Where are
Yeah.
the roadies waking up
Yeah.
and just like waking me up as well? I
Yeah,
love to be
exactly.
surrounded by people. So when I come back home, it feels weird to sleep in my own bed. It feels
Yeah.
weird to not to roll.
Yeah, exactly. No rocking.
And it's hard to explain to my friends because they're like, we don't even know how you can live on a tour bus for more than a
Yeah.
month.
Yeah, exactly. They think you must go crazy. No, I love it actually. It's very
I
nice.
love it. I
It's like
love
a
it. I
school
love
trip.
I know. So
So,
you had to cancel some tours as well, right? The one with Evanescence got canceled. Any other gig? I mean, the summer
yeah,
gig probably.
all the festivals are canceled, of course, and we had a
Yes.
really busy schedule with festivals this year as well. So I'm really, yeah, disappointed about that. But everything was postponed, luckily. So far as we know, we can postpone everything, and I just hope that yeah, eventually it will happen. That's the most important thing, I think, for everyone in, you know, people that work for us, for everyone actually. So it's
Yeah.
I'm looking forward to it also to do it
Yeah,
again.
I know, me too.
Oh.
Me too. We had to cancel two tours,
Two
one
tours
in
even.
Asia. We were supposed to go to different places. We were supposed to go to Japan, to Australia,
Oh my God.
Dubai,
Oh
Thailand
my.
for the
Oh
first
my God.
time.
Okay.
And then we were supposed to go to the North America and Canada again, but
Yeah.
everything
Yeah. Everything's just is it postponed?
gone.
Is it
Some
postponed?
of it is postponed, like the tour we were supposed to do with Apocalyptica has been moved
Yeah.
to next year, January
Okay.
next year.
Okay. Oh, that's nice.
About the other gigs, I don't know. Probably festival will have the same bill next
Yeah.
year,
Yeah.
which is going to be even weird. Like it's like one year never happened.
Yeah, exactly. Like everything was frozen somehow, and then everybody's, well, what I do think a good thing about it is when it finally does start, everybody goes crazy, I think. Everybody goes
Yes.
wild, like, oh, we've missed this.
That's true. I'm wondering how our feelings as artists will be
Yeah.
as well. You know, to be on stage and just like, what is happening? Because once you stop the like to be on tour, it's a continuous
Yeah,
cycle. So
cycle.
whenever you
Yeah.
stop, it's like, I haven't been on tour for like 3 months. What am I gonna do now?
Yeah,
How
yeah. But what happens to the rest of my life now? How am I
exactly.
gonna fill my time? I'm not used to it. I've read all the books, seen all my friends. Okay, what's next?
That's
Yeah, well.
true. That is true. But listen, I mean, there is a lot of stuff going on anyway. I mean,
Yeah, of course, there's still
you.
enough, yeah, new things that are nice to enjoy. And of course, I'm also have a family, so it's also nice to be with my kids here, and I enjoy that
I
very
bet.
much.
I
But
bet they're
it's
so happy.
yeah, they're happy. They're happy that they're not going yet. Yeah,
Yeah. Yet
we.
again, you found the time to release a new single.
Yeah, we did. Yeah, exactly. Well, that was a little bit because of the fact that we were going on tour with Evanescence now, and we felt like we'd had a very big tour last year, and the album was released. We thought if we're going to do another tour through Europe, we need to give them, you know, the audience some new songs.
Sure.
Otherwise, everybody's already has listened to all the songs already. It's all old a little bit, although it's only 1 year. But still, you want to give something new and be so excited about something new yourself as well. So we felt like, okay, let's just start writing immediately after the tour last year. And we did in November and recorded in February and hoping to release it around this time as we are doing. But then playing it already live for the audience
Okay.
and festivals. But then yeah, now it got postponed, of course, but we felt like, yeah, we can postpone it as well because it doesn't make sense to release a single without a tour. But
Yeah.
on the other hand, you know, I think everybody needs it now. You know, we all need new things because everybody, you know, the series of music you've listened to, it's all getting, you know, you
It is
want to
true,
have,
though.
yeah, we need new blood. And I think for music and for everything. So I felt like just release it and let's enjoy the moments and see how the responses go because the album is not even finished yet, so.
Yeah, this is great because a lot of people maybe don't know about the marketing plans and just like I'm gonna release a single because it makes sense to
Yeah,
support a
exactly.
record and
Yeah.
something while you're on tour. So I think it's great that you decided to release it anyway, you know, to make fans happy and to
Yeah.
have something exciting to look for, you know, for the next future. Okay,
Yeah,
I'm gonna hear this song now, new
yeah.
stuff. Yay, let's
Yeah.
get excited. They will
Yeah.
eventually come to my
Yeah, exactly.
city to play a real show.
Yeah.
I think it's a great decision that you took.
Yeah, and you know, it's also something we looked for. It's not just only for fans, but also for ourselves. You know,
Yeah.
you work to a certain point, right? And then you have
Yes.
a way to play it live or to share it. And yeah, that's the same for us. And but your album was released in October, Black Animal.
Our record was released in October. That's why we didn't really wrote anything new. We are doing something new, but it's not a new record. We're
Yeah.
preparing a project we cannot talk about, but we're
Oh,
still working behind
exciting.
the scenes. I will tell you later. I will tell you later.
Okay,
I will
cool.
let you
When
know.
the hammer's off. Cool.
Sorry guys. Sorry guys, we can
I'm
talk
not
about
sorry, guys. I'm not sorry, guys. She's telling me
Yes. And what I wanted to ask you, because I mean, I told you that I came prepared, so I've been reading like bios and stuff.
Oh, really?
And
Oh, my God.
what made me really curious was the meaning behind entertain you, that I found really interesting, because I've read that is the urge to satisfy yourselves
Yeah.
before the others.
Yeah, exactly. It's like sometimes just singling out certain people in society, actually, and that you have, how can I say it in the right way? Is that somehow we always need to emphasize how different the other person is. And I think that's, and it comes from the fact that we're always afraid of people who are different. And I've got a lot of friends who are different in some cases. They have a different religion. They are, I've got a lot of gay friends. So in several corners, I have friends who get discriminated on the street, harassed sometimes. And I find it very difficult, and it always makes me very angry. And it's a problem of all times, actually. And well, this and the message is more about, just embrace the beauty of being different, because I think artists are also different. Everybody is different. The people that are different in society, they bring a lot of color, to my opinion. I think we already have a very, well, society could be a little bit more colorful, to my opinion. I like that people are different, and I'm, yeah, it saddens me when people are being treated that way, and they're not here for our entertainment. It's just, they're different. They can't be anybody else than they are. And that's what the song is about, actually.
Yeah, it looks like society tries to conform everyone. So if you
Yeah.
don't belong to a certain
Group.
look, if you don't
Yeah.
belong to a certain kind of mindset, then
Yeah.
there is something wrong with you.
Yeah, exactly.
While if you think about it, like in the past, what was good about a person and the person was going out even more if it was when it was different, when it was
Yeah,
doing
exactly.
something different, something
Yeah,
new,
totally. Yeah, exactly.
which is so weird.
Yeah, and I think there's only two, I think Frank Zappa said the best way. It's like, without deviation from the norm, there's no progress possible. And I think he said, probably was talking about music, but it's in every way. I think every development, that's only possible if people start looking differently to certain situation or problems or people. It's beautiful to be different, and yeah, I don't
I
know. It's
agree.
and it comes from fear mostly, I think. So that's yeah.
You think so? Like you want to belong?
Sorry?
Not you. Like
Yeah.
fear from not belonging, you mean? Or the
Well,
reaction of like not liking something?
no, I think people are afraid of things they don't know, and they're scared of it, and then they
Oh yeah,
try to
that's true.
isolate it.
That
Yeah.
is true as well. That is true as well. But also because they are afraid of something that they don't know, and they think that all those people that they refuse, it's because they don't belong to their standard.
Yeah,
But all
exactly.
the standards are in their minds, because there is no standard. It's like
No,
beauty. You
exactly.
don't like every gorgeous girl. You just like,
No,
okay,
exactly. No.
you don't only need to be beautiful, there must be something more, you
Special,
know.
yeah, special about, yeah, person. Yeah, totally.
Okay, see I completely misunderstood, because when I've read that bio, I thought that there was also something to do with not haters, but thinking about your career and the career of Lacuna Coil as well, where when everything is evolving and it's cool to evolve because life goes on and
Yeah, exactly.
we can't
Behind.
stay where
No.
we were 20 years ago. I thought that that's something to do with someone criticizing your musical steps, or just like,
No.
oh, you know, the typical, you changed, you're not the same anymore, you're not the same you were
Well, we're
20
used
years
to that.
ago. Yeah.
Yeah, but that's not a problem for me. It's I don't because it's also a necessity for me to change. That's so you can relate to that in a way also. But for me, it goes deeper than that. It goes really to the essence of a person, and people rejecting the essence of who somebody is in the core of their being. And that's I think more heavy. And life is already heavy enough, so
Yes.
a little more respect for everybody. So especially
Yes.
a group that is already always being singled out. So.
Especially right now.
Well, there's a lot of things happening in the Netherlands as well, a lot of things happening in Amsterdam as well. So That's, but these things, they come and go and becomes worse, and then it becomes a little bit less worse, and then, but it never goes away, actually. So it's a problem of all times, in my opinion.
Yes, I think so. And speaking about like pure image, I've seen the images of the kid with that face painting, special face painting. What does he represent? Like, it is a, something that he will use on stage?
That's not something we are going to use on stage, but it's more like, for us, it was an image that already existed, actually.
Oh.
And we felt like it really fitted the song, because, and we made it, we changed it, of course, the image. But the thing was that appealed to us is like that we felt the story with it. It was like the boy trying, this is the age of this child of trying to find their own identity. And being rejected for its own identity. He has a mohawk, he tried paint, but he doesn't get the response of, you know, he tries to be, yeah, I don't know, tries to find himself, and he doesn't get response that he had hoped for. So that was the idea behind the mask. And then you have, of course, the filter online for people. It's like saying, okay, everybody has been singled out once in their life, but how does it, we can identify maybe with the people who are, just try, you know, the filter is like it's like a support for those people.
Okay. I saw some pictures of your band members.
Yeah.
is there a filter, as soon as we were on Instagram, is there an Instagram filter that people can use to?
Yeah,
because I couldn't find it. I swear,
it's a smiley with stars around it. And when you press on it, there's a, like, okay, you can press here, it says, and then you get the filter on.
I'm going to try it. I'm going to post a picture of myself with that. I love like filters, you know. I'm silly like that. Everything weird I like. What can I do?
I saw the Chewbacca movie. But it was you, right? Underneath it?
No, the one that was singing? No, that is a fan of ours called Amy.
Oh, really?
That
oh,
made a video she you. Has. But there is a real mask of Chewbacca that if you open your mouth, like, makes that sound for real. Okay. But I thought that it was hilarious. So I was like, yeah, this is my voice in the morning. I thought that it was so cool to repost, even if it's an older post that I didn't notice.
Yeah, it doesn't matter. Things are just fun. And I love the picture of you dressed up and I want to break free with the mustache. That's hilarious.
That was actually from a show that I did with some friends of mine, where they have a tribute band that cover Queen, and I love Queen, so they invited me years and years ago, and we started, you know, to play shows together because I was having too much fun singing with them, and I started to bring something more visual to the shows, and we are doing this thing in which, you know, I'm dressed like this, and the real singer of the band sings dressed this way, so we're doing this this sort of a cat fight, you know, with our duster on stage. It's so much fun. We like to keep it funny. I mean,
I really thought it was a new picture. I thought it was really you.
No.
From that makeup at home, I thought, oh my God, what a brilliant idea. I love it, you know?
No, I didn't take it that far. That's the top that I can do at home. But it was amazing. It was a great experience. So I thought that it would have been perfect. It was like, I want to break free. Perfect picture.
Yeah, for this time. Exactly.
I had to repost it. Yeah. And I love, you know, like everything fun, everything nerdy, geeky. I'm a little kid inside, and I will be forever. So any chance that I have to do something. I know that some people might think that you, at times you should be a grown up, but to me, to be a grown up sounds like your heart is dead. You don't have any passions anymore, you don't want to have fun anymore, you're not enjoying the little things anymore. It sounds really sad to me. I don't want to think about life in terms of like stages. You're young and you can do some things, and from after 30 you have to be like that, and from after 50 you have to be like that. I think that you should always be young with the spirit. You should always enjoy,
I love that idea. I totally agree with you. I think that's also something that society does more of the times, you know, most of the time you have to fit in a certain picture again. But that's a good thing about that we're being in music, that people don't expect us to be normal. You know, you must be a little bit crazy to even music.
What do you mean? You're not dressed up all the time. Yeah. What do you mean? You don't sing all the time. What do you mean? You're not wearing heels all the time.
No. Yeah, exactly.
No. So no, we wear jog pants at times.
Yeah, exactly. All the time. Now that this, from the waist down, it's all jog.
Yeah. Like pajamas.
Yeah, you know, nice blouse, but underneath it's just jogs, guys.
like, you know, if we were working in an office, we would be, you know, with a tie and just like having conference calls. Like, hey, how are you? Yeah. Underneath.
Did you see the CNN guy who was wearing actually his shirt for an interview, but he didn't see that he was not complete, that he was, that you could see he was still in his boxer shorts. So he was wearing a shirt. He just put it on. He thought, I'm just going to sit for the camera. Nobody's going to see my boxer shorts. And it was, oh, yeah. I loved it. Yeah.
I want to see it. I want to see it. I'm going to go on YouTube and check if it's there.
Yeah, you should, because it was
good,
like,
job.
It was viral, so it was.
I bet. Maybe he did it on purpose, because I mean, come on.
I think a lot of people. There are more people out there who wants to be connected to their inner child than they will admit in daily life. So yeah.
Yeah, I see a lot of people connected with questions. I know that the Lacuna guys are on and they say hi. They say like, oh, please say hi.
Hello, Lacuna guys.
And say hi to your guys as well.
Yeah, I will. I'm not sure if they're here. I didn't check every name underneath it, but it goes so fast. So many people.
Yeah, I know. Sometimes I don't even have time to read it. But well, anyway, I've seen a lot of fun stuff going on with you guys on tour as well. I've seen you like wearing a onesie, a rabbit onesie with your friend and carrots. I want to know how the carrot thing started.
How did it start?
I thought it was so funny. I saw it and was just like, okay, they're gonna eat carrots. And for some reason got stuck with me.
Yeah, no, well, the thing was is that we went on tour and we felt like, okay, after the show, what's the best thing to wear to onesie, actually, you know? I don't care how, you know, they see me in dressed up on stage and I just want to be me afterwards, you know, just comfortable and this nice and furry and soft. Onesie is really cool. And we were in Amsterdam for a show and we went outside to have a coffee and we passed the shop and they had these onesies with huge ears, these bunny suits, and we're like, oh my god, and it's so nice and soft, and we said, we're buying both of them, you know, we're gonna buy one and we're gonna be in the tour bus and we're gonna surprise everybody with our bunny suits. and then we got some fans saw us walking with these bunny suits to the buses because somehow they got very close and we didn't see them. Actually, it wasn't supposed to be seen actually by everyone, but then we got caught on camera. And they started bringing us carrots every time. So after the show, during the show, having bunny ears on, it was like becoming a running gag a little bit. But it was fun.
I loved it. So because you could tell that you guys were genuinely having a good time.
Yeah.
I totally loved it. And for the reason that you said before, I mean, a lot of people are not used to metal band members to be fun.
Crazy in a way, and yeah, how do you say it? More laid back, maybe, because I don't always wear my makeup. I don't always wear my black clothes. I sometimes try to wear pink, and doesn't look as good as black, of course. But still,
I know I'm not wearing white today. Yeah, exactly. I mean, for a change, I was like, wow, I'm gonna wear white. Everybody would be like, what happened?
I'd look classy on you.
What's going on? Man, I should have bring a carrot to just support.
Yeah, you should have. Well, next time, okay?
Yeah. Is that girl that I always see with you your makeup artist?
Yeah,
because I've seen her putting makeup on you, which, by the way, it's amazing. I saw it on pictures on magazines as well.
Yeah, she's a good friend of mine. We became very good friends while working with each other. And first, she wasn't coming on tour with us, but you know, I'm always surrounded by guys and they have their own, you know, it's always a lot of fun because I've got a good connection with the band and with the crew and I enjoy myself always with them. But it is nice to have one lady on the bus. Come on. You know, it's at least for me, I need that sometimes. I need to have a different kind of conversation sometimes and just only about what guys talk about.
Yeah, if they talk, because sometimes they don't even want to have a conversation. Just like, I'm not watching a movie, whatever, bye.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. Headphones on, totally in their own bunk with the laptop and watching a movie.
Yeah, my guys just let me talk. You know, they do stuff and they're just like, they probably listen to me, you know, like typing stuff like.
Stop bothering me.
Exactly. They don't care anymore.
No, you know, at a certain time, you also have told each other everything that you need to know about each other at a certain point. And I don't know, with my friend, I can never stop talking. Somehow there's always something to talk about. And I just drive the boys crazy because I talk a lot. I'm just a very talkative person. So they go crazy. And it's like, okay, I'm just happy that Borka is here.
Are you messy on the bus being the woman? Because I get accused, you know, of being messy on the bus, you know, with shoes everywhere and stuff that I buy. There is always a lot of stuff in the back lounge that I buy on the road. And
yeah, I do buy a lot because I always buy presents for everyone around me. It's like, oh, this is great for this person. Oh, this is amazing. And oh my God, what have you shopped today, Sharon? It's not for me. It's for my friends.
And I can't find it elsewhere in the world.
Yeah, yeah. So I have to buy it now, especially all the Star Wars stuff and Deadpool things that I love. And America is great for that, you know. Also.
Oh my God, yes, yes. And we're so lucky because we get so many gifts as well. And last time I had to keep an R2-D2 in my bunk.
Oh, really?
And
oh,
move it around the bus because, you know, there's so much stuff. And I shop a lot as well. Love vintage stores, which I know that you love.
Oh, me too, yeah. But also vintage stores for comics, you know, like they have the original stuff. That's so cool. And
are you
the most coolest places. Sorry?
Are you collecting comics?
My kids are. And I love the movies. Like, I love Deadpool. Deadpool's my favorite.
Yes.
But they are really collecting stuff. And I'm trying to find stuff for them. But I'm not a really collector of things in that corner. I have so much stuff already that I'm trying to
too much stuff already. Yeah, I'm a weird collector as well. I mean, I don't even call myself a collector. I have a lot of stuff around. Okay. I like stuff.
Yeah, me
too. I like stuff. But I'm the same. My passion when I'm going around is when I'm going like on tour is, you know, just to visit a little bit of the surrounding. But I love vintage store. I love secondhand stores.
Yeah, me
the
too.
The cheap ones in which you can find some treasures.
Yeah,
the red dress that I've worn for
I love
the 20th.
That dress. Amazing.
I found it in a store in the States for $20. Was a one piece $20.
$20? No.
$20. I found it. I was like, this is my dream. I love this dress. It's so beautiful. And it was fitting like a glove. I was like, okay, it's just fine. And then I have decided to wear it because I loved it so much. I love vintage stuff. I love to recycle and reuse clothes.
Yeah, totally. Yeah.
To
totally.
Reinvent them, to cut the sleeves.
Yeah,
do stuff.
Exactly.
Frozen. Equity. totally love it. Let's see the questions that I have. I even did a small drawing.
I have to put a charger in my phone because it's a. One second, Christina. I have to put the charger in because it's down.
Yes. I'm so reading the questions in the meantime. And whoever is following now, I am sorry if the chat will stop all of a sudden because I didn't set up the timing because Instagram only allows 1 hour of
really
and then it blocks the conversation and just like bye.
Really?
So if I don't have time to say goodbye, because what time is it now? How much time do you have a clock? Because
it's 34.
So 34. Okay, so we have like 20 minutes. So just like help me with the timing because we have to stop this live when we are close to 9. I've lost the. No, I wanted to ask you because some fans asked me, how did you meet Amy Lee and how the old tour situation started to be created?
She invited us, she was coming to Amsterdam and we were invited to come to see the show. And then we heard we could go backstage and we did. And we just had a conversation with her and And the most surprising thing is sometimes when you meet somebody new, because I never met her on the festival, I saw her passing by once, but there wasn't download and she was going to the stage, so it was not the moment to approach someone. And I never saw her again on any festival. So they were playing in Amsterdam, they invited us, and I came over with Robert. We went backstage and I had this conversation with her that went into the deep immediately. Like a lot of times when you meet somebody, it's just chit chat, and which is normal, of course. But I'm not the chit chat kind of person. It's nice, but it's for a first time. But I rather go about the deeper layer. That's just that's what I like. I like to talk about things that matter most of the time. And we did, and we talked about the meaning of life within 5 minutes. It was really crazy, but we had a nice glass of red wine and we just connected very well. And when I left with Robert, I was like, I expected a lot, but I didn't expect this to happen, you know, not on the first meeting that you meet someone. And so I was really goosebumps, because that was really a beautiful conversation. And so we stayed in contact, and then just having contact, and they were planning a new tour, and then we were thinking, okay, is there something we can do together, maybe a show or something, and then why not go on tour together? And well, we just came back on tour from the European tour, of course. So we were like, okay, going back on tour again, that's quite quick. But you know, it's cool. I think it's a special, you know, it's like it's nice to have two bands on the bill that all fans probably would like to see, because we're more or less in the same genre kind of music. And I think it's nice for the fans and also for us as persons, because it's nice to go on tour with a girl for once. Like,
and someone you like. I mean, it is important, you know, to have someone you like around you.
Yeah, the older I get, the more important I find it to be on tour with people that I connect with, because you're going to be bumping into each other so many times. It should be fun for everyone, you know? So that's what I'm looking forward to.
Yeah, I cannot even think about touring with someone you don't like. It never happened to us, but when I hear about even bands, you know, not just like more bands, about bands that are having separate tour buses, you know, each member has a separate tour bus. It would drive me nuts, because just the idea of like being around someone that I don't like enough to work with these people, and we only meet on stage and we have to put on a smiling face.
Yeah.
While in reality, I'm like, I hate you. I hate you. Here.
Yeah, there are a lot of big bands actually who did that in the past. It's like, why are you still performing? You know, you already had the fame, you already had the big, you know, success. Why don't do you drag yourself to a concert if you hate each other?
Not only how they do it, but how they got to that point. Because part of the band, so they like each other.
Yeah,
I really don't know how it can happen. But anyway, the tour has been moved to September now. Do you think that in September will be possible to tour? Or, I mean, and then we'll see.
It's going to be very difficult, to be honest, but I hope so still. There's no definite no, but if it's realistic, I don't know at this point, because in the Netherlands, they say you're not allowed to get together above 100 people until September the 1st. So that's going to be difficult. So I don't know how we're going to do that. So because our tour starts in the beginning of September, and then you know, they might change it, they might not change it. So it's very close up, everything. So I don't know if it's realistic, but I hope so. It's something we'll see. And otherwise,
I hope so too. I hope so too, because that means that they will allow shows, and on the 29th,
exactly.
It will be in Milan. So I want to
see. Are you, are you
there? Yes, if I'm here and I'm not around, because I mean, I don't know what will happen in September. No. I will come to see you. Yes. Oh, cool. Yes. I can't wait. So I got a message from a girl that wanted you to describe yourself in 5 words. Here we are. That's like the favorite movie.
I only do that if favorite start.
Pardon?
You have to do it first.
Oh shit. No.
It gives me time to think.
No. Those questions are always horrible, huh? That's like, what's your favorite song? What's your favorite movie? But I don't know. I don't know, because every time I think about, you know, the words to describe yourselves, sometimes they're very bad or very good. So it's hard to stay in the middle.
Yeah,
and so because it's like, you know, how are you? Fierce. And then you come out like, oh, fierce, I'm not afraid of anything, which is not.
Yeah.
Or like dorky, which is, I'm not dork all the time. I'm not stupid.
Exactly.
But yeah, let's fierce.
Well, you kick ass, definitely. So I totally believe that.
Then clumsy, because I'm very, like everything I touch, it falls. I'm very chaotic. Chaotic.
What?
Chaotic. Chaos.
Oh, chaotic. Chaotic.
I am chaos.
Yes. Okay.
Chaotic. I don't know how many did I.
Oh, you have three now. That's three. Three.
Fierce,
chaotic.
Fierce, chaotic, and clumsy.
Clumsy. So that's three.
Dorky. Dorky, geeky. Then it's five. So I will think about the others.
Well, I'll give you three. I'll give you three as well.
Yeah.
I am passionate, and I'm passionate about a lot of things. So I think, of course, not everything, but a lot of things. So passionate, emotional. People tend to see that as a bad thing, but I think it's being in contact with your emotion in a way. So that, and I'm extremely chaotic. And I'm always late. I'm always like 5 minutes.
See,
past
I'm perfectly in time. I'm the opposite. I'm always there.
Oh, really? Oh, I wish I would be like you. I love that.
Totally, totally. I freak out. If I late 1 minute, I freak out.
Oh, really? Oh.
Yeah.
Okay. most of the time I'm a bit late and to everyone's irritation. So, but number five, I don't know yet, but... do you have any other things you want to say to
me? Are you patient or impatient?
Impatient. Very impatient.
Okay. Me too. Yeah. Are you anxious or are you a person that is always in control?
That's very different in different situations. But most of the time, I'm a very stable kind of person. But there are before a show, I really freak out for every show until we are in a more or less on the road for a few shows already. Then it gets less, but I'm always have a lot of anxiety before I go on stage.
Okay, and are you an empathetic person? Empathetic.
I know what you mean. Yes, I hope so.
Okay. Yeah, I'm very, but like if I see someone crying or being sad, I get.
You also cry, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I'm trying to motivate, but I totally feel when someone around me is in pain, I.
That's what I mean with emotional, actually. It's like you're in contact with your own feelings. I think you relate to people.
I like to talk. I'm a big talker, but I also listen a lot.
Okay.
I like to listen to you. How much time do we have?
Like 15 minutes, more or less.
Ooh, 15. Amazing. Ooh. Amazing.
You're still fine. Don't worry. I'll keep an eye on the clock.
Perfect.
So we can say goodbye in time.
Perfect. Speaking of passions, you said that you are very passionate.
Yeah.
I've read that you're very passionate about tennis.
Yes, I love tennis.
I didn't know it.
Do you tennis?
Tell me more about
tennis.
No. I'm the least, I usually started to work out in this quarantine. I'm the laziest person on earth. But now I'm working out. Like it has been like for the last 2 months.
Wow.
I have a treadmill, so I'm using the treadmill. I'm following some YouTube videos. And to be honest with you, I work out because I want to eat more. So that is the goal.
Oh, okay.
But that's at the same time, you know, I use it, you know, to keep in shape for touring because that's my usual workout. So instead of the touring, I'm doing this.
Yeah, that's really good. Well, I try to, but I'm really lazy. So I'm always hoping that somebody brings his tennis record, like Borka, she plays tennis as well, and some crew members. So we've played in Russia. We rented a tennis court. How do you say that? Tennis court? Yeah. Yeah, and also in France, next to a stadium where we were playing as support for Metallica, there was this huge tennis court, and we could play there. And so we were like, "Yeah, brought my record!" And we just a few hours before the show, just playing tennis. It's crazy.
That is a good sport. That is a complete sport because I mean, you're running. It's a powerful.
Yeah, absolutely. And especially when you play against my friend, she likes to place balls in every part of the field. So I'm running my walking and running a lot because of that. So it's a bit of sadistic kind of sport as well.
It is indeed. I was never into tennis because I never got anyone, you know, teaching me or playing with it.
Yeah.
Well, like when I was a little girl, I would play volleyball, even if I'm really short. Of course, it was just for fun. I did dance. I did karate, you know, something more. Cool. A little bit of soccer as well.
Yeah. Oh, really? Wow. Do you like soccer?
Yeah, but then I stopped, you know. Oh, it was just like, yes. I'm not a very...
I also did every sport on there is most almost dancing, ballet, horse riding, but the horse didn't like me very much, so I was always kicked out.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, really, so many times. And then my mom came to film me, and then every time when she came to film me, I had the wrong horse, but there was one horse, and he was called Pepper, and it was the worst horse in the whole
spicy horse.
That's why it was called Pepper, no doubt. And he always kicked me off, and I was always started crying when I had to go on this particular horse, or I would lock myself up on the toilet until the hour was gone and the whole lessons was done. And everyone's, "Sharon, where are you I said, "Oh, I'm really have a stomach ache."
Yeah, no, I can't do it anymore. Let's go to ballet, please.
It was humiliating, but I was only 8 years old, and I wasn't supposed to be riding horses yet because they're really big. You're allowed to ride on small horses, but not big horses. And this was a huge horse, but this was in Suriname, because I lived there with my parents. And this was just a farmer who had, who rented out horses. And didn't stick to the rules for kids. So there was, normally it goes about differently. So when I had gotten to a proper person who would teach me in a proper way, then I probably had a better, experience with horses. But it never happened after it. Even when I went to Holland, there was on the islands, you could... rent a Shetland horse, you know what it is? The really small ones, but they're very spicy.
Oh, yeah.
I like didn't
ponies.
Know that.
Not ponies.
Yeah, very small. Like midget ponies, you know? And
I thought midget ponies, funny, sorry.
Yeah. Well, and you know, they were very small, so I thought, well, you know, I'll probably be able to ride these, but these are the most stubborn ever. And they ran away with me over the beach. So my parents were running after me, trying to catch the horse, and I was gone. And it just ran back to the stables again. And yeah, it was so humiliating. I'm never going to be on the back of a horse again, ever.
The horse was like, whatever.
Yeah, whatever.
Do it my way, yo.
I'm home.
Yeah, I'm imagining the glasses, thug life. With you screaming on top of the horse.
Well, you're probably right. It was like that. Yeah.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
So. I can imagine. I'm picturing the image. It's awesome.
Yeah. You're sadistic.
Honestly, yes, I know. No, it's just
me too. I'm very sadistic. Yeah.
But did you say that you supported Metallica once?
Yeah, a few
How
times.
Was it? How because
was
I can't imagine Metallica fans and Slayer fans to be the hardest one to get through. I went to a show in Milano,
yeah,
a little bit out of Milano, where Faith No More was supporting Metallica. And I mean, Faith No More are amazing.
I love them. They're
a great band. They have a lot of fans around the world. But in that occasion, fans were just like booing them out, you know, and I was like, how can you boo them out of the stage? Like,
Faith
No More. So I can't imagine, you know, that supporting those kinds of bands must be scary.
Yeah, well, I must say we played a few times for, I think, four times or maybe five times before as a support. And it depends
on the country. Was it in Holland?
No, not in the Netherlands. No, we played in Germany and in Spain and in France. I think we did two times France. And in France, it was heavy because it was not their cup of tea, you know. And but in Spain, people were really cheering. They were really, you know, we had a proper response, really cool. That was really nice. But also because, I don't know, and it was... maybe because the other festival where we were playing in France was just a one-off from Metallica with one or two support bands. And in Madrid, it was in Spain, it was with on the festival, on the mainstream festival where they had Metallica, and we were playing there as well, just in front of them. And there were a lot of people that knew us. So it was not just metal audience, but also a very mixed audience.
Well, no, we never played with them. I mean, we met them along the way in different festivals, but we never like had a, you know, proper support slots with them. And I would love to tour with them because, I mean, I like them as people, but must be weird to tour. And
yeah, it is. But it's, you know, it depends a little bit on where it's taking place, I guess. And every day is different. So we did it a few times and we liked it because we liked the band and we were just...
Of course. And then, I mean, you're doing your stuff anyways.
Yeah.
I mean, that's always
exactly.
Worthy and that's a great...
Yeah, you just hope to win, how I say also, to win some hearts that maybe you convince somebody there out there that to join, you know, to like your band. And, you know, we never stopped earlier or anything. We just played our thing and we enjoyed it. You know, just, you know, if there's an audience that doesn't wanna interact with us, we just play our thing and do our show because we'll have fun anyway with each other. So it's...
That's the most important thing, right? You know, to be on tour and just like, whatever will happen, whatever, you know, they like it or not.
Yeah, exactly. But then it becomes really important that you like each other when you're playing together with each other on the stage. If you already hate each other going on stage and then play for an audience that doesn't like you, then yeah, that's even more difficult, of course. So.
When you're playing a concert, are you totally focused on what you're doing or you're more just like, let's have fun with it because like it's almost automatic? Because I find myself to enter in a completely different dimension sometimes. So I'm feeling that I am so focused that I forget about, not forget about what's around me, but I'm having a good time, but at the same time, I stay focused and control. How was your attitude on stage? How do you go on stage? Just like...
Well, it's very different every time. I try to get in this like trance, because then I think I give the best of me, because then I really dive into the emotion of the music. And I can let everything go because I'm a complete control freak. I see everything that happens, mm-hmm. even when somebody's filming in the audience when it's not allowed, or you know, things, people fighting. I see everything. I go crazy, and it's like I just want to let it go and just accept when something happens, like fighting or something. I try to be focused on that always, that everything goes okay in the audience. But the best thing for me is to really glide into the music. Because then I can give the best of myself always. So it's not, and what you say, you try to get a little bit of surroundings around you and be less of a control freak. That's the best.
That is true. It's not easy. It's not easy to take care of everything.
Exactly.
And also being focused on your space on stage, you know, to not to be falling apart, you know, over the monitor.
Yeah, the monitors and stuff like that. Yeah, exactly.
Have you ever failed on stage?
No, but band members have. No, and I did get into the fire almost because the wind was standing towards the stage and we had these flames and everything. And Robert pulled me back just in time because, you know, with these dresses, sometimes they're from different kind of fabrics. Sometimes it's from silk, but sometimes you have synthetic stuff on and it gets fire, then then it's really bad because it really sticks to your skin and then you really get burned. So, but it never happened. Robert did fall from a stage once because he had to go from the stairs towards the stage. It was in Madrid and we had the showcase and there was no, you can hold the staircase. How do you call that?
I don't know the word.
Yeah.
But
You know what I mean, right? So the whole concert, there was none. You could only walk down. And it was dark because we had to get on stage in the dark. And he was like, yeah, I'm going on. And he forgot there was, you had to go down the stairs. So he walked off the stairs sideways. So he landed on his back 2.5 meters high. He fell down. And it was really stupid, my reaction, because I started laughing really loud. I was so in shock. I started laughing. And everybody was shocked about me because I started laughing. Like,
because you were laughing. Sorry if I'm laughing, but I'm
yeah, it's like, oh, real scene. Okay, yeah, exactly. But then he said, like, oh, I'm okay. And then we started laughing all together because everybody was so shocked. Like, oh, my God, he could have broken something. But he landed on his back, didn't hurt himself, luckily. But these things happen, like you say, like tripping over stuff and so.
No, yeah, I know. I fell a couple of times, yeah. I fell on Auspice. I remember I fell off the stage.
Really?
I don't even know how I survived because it was really high. And I remember, you know, walking around and coming back, you know, with the security just like helping me out to go back on stage. But the guys are laughing as well because, as
really?
I said, I'm so clumsy.
So these two.
they're used to it.
They don't mind anymore.
Yeah.
they didn't expect this to happen, but they know you're clumsy, right? That's what you said.
Yeah, they know that it's gonna happen somehow, you know, sometimes.
So how did the audience react?
No, the audience usually is worried because, of course, they don't want me to get hurt.
So well, of like,
but as soon as they see that I'm fine and I start laughing, they laugh as well, and it ends
up
as, you know, like a comedy thing that everybody enjoys, just like, okay, she's okay. But we had other episodes, as you mentioned, where things got dangerous within the crowd, you know, people fighting.
Oh my God, yeah.
Or getting hurt, you know, I feel really bad when I see someone passing out because it's too hot or because they get compressed from the rest of the crowd. It happened a few times, and every time, you know, I go make sure that the person is okay because I feel so bad.
Yeah, totally.
That someone came to the show, you know, to enjoy the concert and then just like missing the show. And,
yeah,
and
because of that. Yeah, totally.
Bad. And once I remember there was a guy in the States. It was a show with, I think it was a show with Heaven Dust, and we were opening for them. And this guy started to be.
3 minutes.
Yeah.
Oh,
2 minutes. Keep it short, super short. By the way, this guy was having this birthday, so he was extremely drunk and started to bother anyone around him. And they started punching him to the point that this guy was bleeding from his nose. So I saw what happened, so I was just like, come here. You come here just to save him from the crowd.
Yeah.
And I bring him on stage, and he said that it was his birthday, completely drunk. And everybody cheered, including the ones that punched
him. No!
So I was like,
God.
What the hell? Yeah, maybe we saved a life and everything.
Oh, yeah, it's cool that you took him on stage, though.
But anyway, I'm so sorry that we have to end this live.
Yes, and thank you for everyone who is watching. And thank you, Christina, for doing this because I loved it.
I loved it. Let's do it again because I had a
good time. Totally.
For
totally.
Real.
And, you're going to tell me when this is gone, of course, when everybody else is left, which is a nice project you're working on. So I'm curious.
I will let you know, like, five seconds after.
Yeah.
So well, thank you so much.
Thank
you, Sharon. Thank you so much. Thank you, everyone, for watching.
Everyone, thank you.
See you on the road, hopefully soon.
Yeah, totally. Can't wait.
Bye.
Ciao.
Bye, ciao. Actually, before we go, we let them take a screenshot like this.
Yes.
Perfect.
Yay.
Ciao, Sharon. Have a great night.
You
love
too.
You.
Bye-bye.